Hi and welcome to all petroleum engineers and students from around the world in this event that brings together several countries, including Greece, Egypt, Britain, Germany, Yemen, and Azerbaijan, and more, in one forum for knowledge exchange and mutual development. Our second training lecture today is titled Evaluation of Full Completion from Traditional to Smart Technology, presented by an engineer with over 15 years of experience in the oil and gas industry. Mr. Mahmoud Faraj Radwan from Egypt, who holds a baccalaureate degree in petroleum engineering from Al-Azhar University in 2007, experience as an instructor in upstream oil and gas in Egypt and the Gulf Cooperation Council, head of subsurface and integrity operation department at Amal Petroleum Company. Over 9 years of expertise as a senior well intervention, integrity, and completion engineer on offshore platforms. Certification in IADEC well chart for well surfacing oil and gas operation representative. IWCF well intervention level 4 and an IADEC H2S card certificate. We are delighted to have such a distinguished professional with us today in our event IPES, and we look forward to his valuable insights in our season. Mr. Mahmoud, please go ahead.
Yes, good day everyone, and I hope all is well. Today we are starting from day two. I'm pleased to be a part of your great event and this international event. We are talking about one of the main element or one of the main phase in the well life cycle. As we are highlighting, what about the evolution of well completion from traditional to smart completion? And how is the technology coming? How is the development and the researches coming from more than 150 years to apply? What about the technology? How is the construction? How is the well completion for our wells? Even what about the innovation? What about the new technology? All we are highlighting in our presentation. When we are starting from the journey of the well completion of any kind of well, we are highlighting what about the operation coming after drilling operation. It's very important to know that the well completion is considered as one of the main element or one of the main phases in the well life cycle. It will define what about the maximum productivity, what about the maximum return on investment, how is the value of oil, how is the value of gas, and also what about the objective, what about the targets, and how is the reservoir strategy will be offered or will be achieved in our well life cycle. So again, the topic titled Evolution of Well Completion, starting from traditional to smart technology. Prior to start our presentation or our course in day one, we are starting with how is the 5 ways to control the climate change. We have 5 ways to control the climate change. At first, green your commute. And the second one, how is the conserve of your fuel or your energy? And at third, you have to get an energy audit done. And by force, we have to add more and more trees in our world. And the last one, to reduce and reuse and recycle to identify what about the controlling of climate change. Again, what about the 5 ways to control the climate change? At first, green your commute. At second, to conserve fuel. By third, to get an energy audit done. So the fourth one, to plant trees, more trees in our world. And the last one, to reduce, reuse, and recycle. So when we are starting at first, what about the course objective or how is the objective coming inside the area for well completion? The main objective that to provide a knowledge of traditional and smart well completions. How is the component? How is the different design? What about the technology? How is the challenges inside the area for reservoir management, inside the area for production strategy, and so on. So in this case, we are starting our journey today with agenda. What about our agenda? Agenda starting from introduction to well completion process. After that, we are highlighting what about the different types of well completion configurations. And then we are considering what about the traditional and describe what about the traditional or conventional completion equipment. After that, we are go through how is the industry coming for the new technology of a smart completion. What is the exact definition for the smart completion? Yes, after that, we are considering what about the case history or case or the history for the smart completion technology. After that, we are highlighting what about the smart completion business value and how the benefits coming from the smart completion technology. After that, we are describe and identify what about the smart completion equipment. How is the technology, how is the smart completion will be combined with the artificial lift technology. And we have more case studies, more examples about the smart completion. And by the end, we are highlighting what about the references or credits when we are talking about the smart completion technology. So we can start with a term for well life cycle. As everyone working in the area for upstream oil and gas industry, working with the wells, oil wells or gas wells, water wells, and so on. So how is the well life cycle started? We are highlighting that the well life cycle started from what about the basis of design? It's the first phase. And after that, we will go through the second phase as the design phase. After that, the third phase will be construction phase. Here is our work inside the area for well completion. As the construction phase is considered in the two area for drilling and well completion. So it's considered one of the main phase in the well life cycle, and it controlled all of the operation coming regarding what about the after coming operation regarding operational phase, regarding intervention phase, and when we are reaching to the final phase of the BNA or a plug and abandonment. So again, the construction phase is one of the main important in well life cycle. So when we are highlighting the term for construction, this term is considered any drilling and well completion operation in the area for how is the development, how is the exploration area, how is the appraisal wells, and so on. So when you are talking about the area for a basic construction for any kind of well, we are starting from how the well will be drilled. After that, we are running casing and perform a cement job. So the ideal case here, as when we are talking about the area for casing and cement integrity, so the casing design and also the cement placement technique, it will govern all operation in the area for well construction. So the first step to drill your well, after that you are running casing, and after that you will perform a cement, and you will go through the completion process. Here we are highlighting what about the typical casing design. Typical casing design here is started from the 30-inch conductor, as like this, as this the first conductor pipe. It will be hammered or drived in the well. And after that, we are drill the surface casing. Surface casing here is 20 inch surface casing. Surface casing will reach to the casing show as 0.4 here. And the cement as the green color in the left side will start it from the surface casing show from here till we are reaching to the surface. This is the recommended practice coming from the EBI standard, coming from the well control like IWSF or IEDC forum. Again, we are highlighting what about the next casing. Next casing will be intermediate casing and cement, as you see in the left side also. The cement will be started from the intermediate casing show here. Here is the 13C3 8-inch casing, and will end off the overlap between the surface casing and the intermediate casing. This overlapped area, it will be more than 150 feet in the area for overlap, as it will be have a very integrated cement and high quality of cement integrity between casing and the other area. And after we are considering the next casing is the production casing. This typical example as 958 inch casing as production casing. And also, as you see here in the left side, the green cement will reach to overlap between the intermediate casing and production casing to reach more than 150 feet of the good and the high bond high quality of cement. And we are finalized with the liner. Liner, it's not it's a casing considered a casing, but not reach to the surface. At normal way, it's considered as the cement to be along all lengths of the liner from bottom to till top of liner or the liner hanger. So again, the typical casing design here or the typical well construction, it's considered how is the casing and cement integrity. Because the cement integrity, it's very important to protect any kind of hydrocarbon migration, also to give a mechanical isolation, a mechanical barrier, also to give you the opportunity and the chance for any kind of production optimization, even in the future, even if you are adding any kind of interval in the coming or in the upcoming days of the production of oil. So again, the casing and cement integrity is very, very important in the area for well construction phase. And after that, the second area, we are talking about what about the well completion process. At first, you are starting from how is the introduction to a well completion. So when you are starting with the completion process or definite case or definite phase here, we are defining what about the area for how to define or how to identify the term for well completion. The well completion is considered as the design, selection, and installation of tubular tools and any kind of equipments or accessories in the well bore for the purpose of conveying or pumping or controlling the production or injection fluids inside the area for reservoirs. So in this case, we have three basic functions of a completion. At first, the well completion, it's the only way to let reservoir or formation fluid into the well from where it can will be flow or will be coming to the surface. Is this the first function or the main function of the well completion? The second function of the well completion to keep over or underlying water out of the well. This is the second function or the second area for well completion. And the third one to keep the formation out of the well. So again, the completion process, it's considered as the design, selection, and illustration of tubular tools or any kind of accessories, any kind of downhole equipment into the well bore. To allow or to define how is the formation fluid coming to the surface or bump it inside the reservoir for any kind of injection phase. So again, we have three basic function of accumulation. At first, let a reservoir fluid into the well from where it can go through the surface area. The second one to keep over any unwanted fluid like water out of the well, and the third one to keep the formation out of the well. So in this case, any kind of job, any kind of operation, any kind of mission in your life, At first, you have to define what about the objective. And let me give an example for this. If you are woke up early any days, you are asking yourself, what about the objective? What about the mission in this day? So again, if you are consider any kind of operation, if you are consider any kind of process, if you are consider any kind of technology, you are consider what about the objective from this design, or what about the objective for this process. The top level completion design objectives, starting from at first, we have to define the area for how to optimize the production. So when you are asking all people working in the area for upstream oil and gas industry, what about the term for optimization? Anyone can answer, please. After raise your hand, you can answer.
You can raise your hands and answer. Yes, Abdullah, you can unmute yourself.
Optimizing production, meaning the maximum production with the lowest cost.
Yes, expected answer. All people consider that the optimum condition or the optimized production as the maximum production with the lowest cost. But actually, optimum production or optimize the production, it's a maximum value of produced oil and gas, but it's considered the life of reservoir or life of well. So again, when you are consider what about the term for optimized production, how to maximize the oil and gas gain, and also consider what about the reservoir life cycle. Everyone can consider the cost, it will not be a fair rule in all time. So how is the lower cost, or how is the lowest cost? It will be a fair rule in our operation. So again, the optimized production is how to maximize the oil and gas production coming from your basin or your reservoir, and considering the life cycle of this reservoir or of this well. So the second objective of completion design is how is the adequate, or how is the suitable monitoring and servicing for same well. The third objective, what about the suitable equipment for well environment and the changes? And when you are consider the offshore area, or you are consider the land area, it will be consider what about the environmental regulations? It will consider how is the laws, how is the objectives, and so on. The fourth one, we are considering that the constraint with the reservoir strategy. So we are consistent in the area for how is the reservoir strategy will be applied. In the term for completion design, we are consider the term for how is the production strategy, or how is the exploitation strategy. So there are two main ideas for production strategies. The first one as how fast, and the second one as the how much. What about the difference between this two strategies? The first one as the how fast, it's to consider how to maximize oil and gas production rates with a lower cost, but we are not consider and not achieve the target for how to extend the reservoir lifetime. And the second one as the how much, it will be considered two ideas. The first idea, how to maximize your recoverable oil or recoverable gas, and we are respecting what about the reservoir management and reservoir life cycle. And so again, the second one as the how much, it will be have a priority, and also it will give you more oil and more gas with more time, with more life for your reservoir. One of the main objective also for any kind of completion design to ensure how is the return on investment. In petroleum economics, we are consider one of the main term or one of the main terminology you are using the term for ROI. What about ROI? It's abbreviation for return on investment. So when we are consider how to ensure the return on investment in the process for rule completion, we are consider at first, how is the cost efficient installation? How is the reliability? And also how is the risk management? Every job we are defined in the area for upstream oil and gas industry, we are consider the term for risk management because we are considering that we have a wide difference between the risk and calculated risk. Every job, every action you are considered in our operation, we are considered as hazard or risk. So this risk, it will be calculated, it will be managed, and also it will be assessed and evaluated to mitigate any kind of risk, to remove any kind of risk. At the end of the top level completion design objective, we are consider what about the safe well security regarding environment, regarding QHSE, regarding the regulations. So again, when you are considering what about the top level completion design objective, at first, how to optimize the production. Second, what about the adequate monitoring and servicing? Third one, as the suitable component for well environment and the changes. Also, we are considering the plateau, also the reservoir strategy. What about the plan? What about the development area here? And also, we are ensure the term for ROI or return on investment. It will be achieved through the cost efficient installation, the reliability, and also risk management. And by the end, we are consider what about the safe well security environment regarding the term for quality, regarding the term for QHSE. So in this case, when we are considering and define what about the objective coming from well completion, in this case, we are considering what about the well completion design process. Again, when we are considering the design philosophy of well completion is to maximize the profitability. Again, the design philosophy of well completion is to maximize profitability. How to maximize profitability? To maximize the profitability coming for well completion, it's maximize the profitability by, at first, how to maximize the well hydrocarbon recovery. And the second one, how to considering the full hydrocarbon resource life cycle or the reservoir life cycle. Again, when you are considering what about the philosophy of any kind of well completion, the philosophy is how to maximize the profitability coming by at first, how to maximize the well hydrocarbon recovery. And by second, we are consider the full life cycle of reservoir and also the hydrocarbon continuity or the deliverability of the hydrocarbon. So in this case, when we are consider how is the well completion process is starting from what? At first, we are considering that the process coming for, at first, we are defining how is the well objective. So in this case, we are asking all people to share with us, what about the area for well objective, or what about the completion objective? It's to consider a lot of parameters. This parameters is considered of what? Any person can answer on this. When we are defining the objective of well completion, what about the input data, or what about the feed through we are using?
Anyone can unmute themselves and answer the question, please. Abdullah Azanati, go ahead.
Yes, you can go. Yeah.
Abdullah, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I didn't raise my hand.
You are raising your hand.
Yeah, okay, okay.
Okay. MMM, you can unmute yourself and go ahead.
Harunjur Mahmoud, I think there are many objectives of well design. One of this is the number of reservoirs that we are going to produce. The objective from the well, is it a production well or an injection well, and many others. Yeah.
Regarding also, what about the surface constraints? Yes. Also, what about the future requirement or the workover requirement or any kind of well servicing requirement? You are consider or you are touching what about the well completion objective and how to start the process. So again, when you are starting the process for any kind of well completion, at first you have to define what about the well completion objective. So to define what about the well completion objective, at first we are highlighting how is the reservoir strategy regarding what about the exploitation or production strategy. As we mentioned, we have two main ideas here. The first one is the how fast, and the second one is the how much. The second input data for your completion targets or objective, what about the surface constraints? Because in a lot of areas or a lot of fields, we have a lot of surface constraints regarding what about the surface facilities, what about the maximum rate, how the water cut, and so on. Also, one of the main input data here, what about the lifetime requirement? Everyone can ask himself, what about the lifetime for this reservoir or the lifetime for this well? Because of what? Because when we are considering the lifetime, we are considering the maximize of the profitability coming from the well completion. One of the input data here, how is the monitoring requirements? In the conventional or traditional completion, the monitoring requirements coming from the surface area. But in the smart completion, we are considering the downhole data, we are considering the sensors, we are considering how is the integration between all of the data, how is the optimization, and so on. Also, one of the main input data inside the area for well objective, what about the area for workover, how is the frequency of recompletion, and also by the end, we are consider what about the cost model. So at first, when you are defined what about the well completion objective, and you are targeting the well proposal, after that you will define what about the full details about completion objective, about the completion project or the completion process. Then we are consider how to confirm the visibility. Visibility study, it's a very, very critical in our industry. Because of what? Because in many cases, when you are completing any kind of oil well or gas wells or injector well, you are consider the main objective. You are targeting a fixed data. You are targeting a random objective. So the visibility can consider to be confirmed in the area for well completion. So to confirm the visibility, after that you are considering how is the completion configuration coming? So in the area for completion regarding any kind of well, we are considering two model or two area. The first one coming from how is the reservoir pressure with a certain fluid or with the formation fluid coming from the area of drainage or of the area of reservoir till we are reaching to the area for perforation or the sand phase. So again, this considers the area for inflow, like when we are considering the term for IBR as the inflow performance relationship. And after you are calculating or you are estimating the inflow model, you are considering the area for outflow model. So when you are considering the two models of inflow and outflow, you are considering a lot of data or you are targeting a lot of data. At first one, we are considering what about the field data, how is the well geometry of reservoir, how is the vertical well, how is the deviated well, how is the horizontal well, how is the multilateral well, and so on. Also, we are define the data for how is the communication between reservoirs, what about the rock and fluid data, how is the stimulation requirement regarding matrix acidizing, regarding hydraulic fracturing, and so on. Also, we are considering if you are facing with any kind of sand production, so the sand control, it will be highlighted in the area for inflow and outflow model, and finally in the area for well completion configuration. Also, one of the main term here is to consider what about the tubing size. Everyone working with any kind of software like Prosper, like PipeSim, and so on, considering the area for what about the tubing size sensitivity. How is the tubing size sensitivity will affect the rate, will affect the lifetime, will affect in the area for outflow performance, and will be considered in this area. So one of the area also we are considering, how is the production coming from this well? At first, if you have energy, like if you have a pressure, it will be a strong drive in your system. It will be produced by natural flow. But after a certain time, maybe from day one of your production, we'll consider or we'll highlight what about the artificial lift. So the artificial lift have a certain criteria to select between the different artificial lift techniques or methods regarding gas lift, regarding ESP, regarding jet pump, regarding sucker rod pump, and so on. So now we are consider one of the main question we are highlighting in the term for well completion. When you are targeting a reservoir, this reservoir with a high gas liquid ratio, and you have a gas, and you are consider one of the main artificial lift will be used. Anyone can describe what about the high priority for the artificial lift here? It will be for ESP, for sucker rod, for what? Anyone can describe or answer on this?
You can raise your hand and unmute yourself to answer the question.
So
there is an answer in the chat box.
Yes. So
ESP.
If we are consider the area for a certain well have a high gas liquid ratio, we are considering at first we are considering the area for gas lift because of what? Because the gas is the main source here, and also we are considering the high gas liquid ratio will affect on the area for pumping unit. Regarding ESP, regarding the other type of artificial lift pumps. So again, when you are consider the area for inflow model, outflow model, we have a lot of details or a lot of input data to define the inflow and outflow, considering the field data, considering the well geometry of reservoir, considering the communication inside the area of reservoir, the rock and fluid data, the stimulation technique or the stimulation methodology, the sand control if you have any kind of sand production. Also, what about the tubing size and how is the sensitivity between the large size and small size of tubing? And by the end, we are considering the artificial lift selection. Even if you are considering the two main item, here is the inflow and outflow. After that, you are define what about the detailed design process and how is the equipment, how is the accessories inside the area of completion. Then we are consider how to operate and maintain your well. And after that, you will ask the designer, how is the requirement will be achieved? The requirement will be achieved, yes or no? So again, if you are considering a lot of requirements and this requirements will be achieved, it will be visible. And if no, it will be not visible. So again, the answer in all of this, how to optimize the solutions. So when you are considering the term for requirements, what about the achievable target here, or what about the achievable item here? At first, we are consider the well-designed model. And the second one, we are consider or highlighting the term for facilities model. Because of what? Because the well design model and facilities model, it will be integrated in same network to achieve the target, So the hydrocarbon or the formation fluid will go through the right way and will be able to treated or will be able to processed at surface. And the end of this process or every phase we are considering the well life cycle, we are considering the term for how is the cost versus benefits. It's considered as the analysis or considered as the performance standard, and also may be considered as KPI. KPI of what? It's considered the term of key performance indicator. How is your objective? How is your requirements? And how is the achievement of this requirement or objective? So again, the cost versus benefit or analysis, it will be have a great tool to define what about the success of your technology, how is the performance of your well, and also to evaluate and to assess any kind of new technology, you have to perform also a visibility study. So again, the design process have a great philosophy. This great philosophy is considered as the how to maximize the profitability regarding two main items here. At first, how to maximize the well hydrocarbon recovery, and second one, how to well respecting and considering the full life cycle of reservoir and your well. So in this case, when we are highlighting the term for the completion design parameters, at first we are highlighting the term for location. So in the area for location, in our worldwide upstream industry, we have two main location as land operation, even will be a remote area or urban area. And offshore it have two considerations. The first one as the shallow depths or shelf operation, and the second one as the deep water. So the development in the area for landfills or the area for offshore, it will be different. So the technology have to be meet the targets, have to meet the requirements for location inside the area for land or inside the area for offshore. So the second target here or the second parameter here will be considered the term for what about the reservoir. So inside the area for reservoir, we have a lot of parameters here. We are starting from what about the physical parameters of your reservoir. It will be starting from what about the depths, how is the pressure, how is the temperature, how is the hole size or the area of reservoir as a drainage area, and also what about the shape, and finally you are consider what about the height or thickness of your formation. So when we are considering the area for the rock composition, we are considering what about the sandstone or any kind of carbonate rocks or fractured rock. And also we are considering what about the type of formation. It will be consolidated or weak formation. And also we are considering the cementation material. All of this physical parameters and also all of the rock composition are highlighting what about the term for rock properties. The rock properties here, it's very, very critical because of what? Because a lot of parameters here, it will be highlighted in the area for well completion, like the permeability, like porosity, like fluid saturation, and also wettability. And when you are considering the term for a reservoir properties, we are considering the area for what about the driving mechanism or production mechanism. In many cases, we have a water drive, a solution gas drive, gas cap, injection regarding water injection or gas injection, and also regarding how the artificial lift will be applied. And the answer, the question here for all people or any kind of person can share the answer of this question. The question is, what about the main benefits or the main function of the area for production mechanism inside of well completion? What about the value of the production mechanism in the area for well completion? Anyone can describe this, please? Please raise your hand and share the answer. Okay.
I think the production mechanism will affect the production rate from our well. So depending on the production rate, we can design the tubing and so on.
Yes.
Also the production mechanism may affect, for example, the design of the perforation, how to perforate our well. For example, if we have a water drive reservoir, we may perforate away from the water aquifer and so on. And also, if we have a gas cap, we may perforate away from the gas cap.
So you are touching a lot of parameters. So again, the production mechanism, it's very, very critical in the well completion process. Because of what? Because we are considering what about the tubing selection, how is the future performance, how is the lifetime, and so on. So it will be a great factor to consider the production mechanism. It's one of the main idea for reservoir property. So again, when you are considering the area for reservoir fluid have a certain or have a specific physical parameters. All of this physical parameters, it will be governed in the area for well completion process. At first, what about the oil density regarding the ABI gravity, regarding the gas gravity, regarding the bubble point pressure, regarding the viscosity, regarding the gas oil ratio, and also water air ratio. All of the physical parameters for any kind of formation fluid, it will govern a lot of factors inside the area for well completion. And the other factor is how the chemical properties, like composition, like what about the origin of crude oil regarding wax and asphaltene, and also what about the corrosive and toxic impurities, and how is the scaling agents. In the area for chemical properties, nowadays, it's very, very critical because a lot of oil and gas wells have a lot of problems regarding scales, regarding wax, regarding asphaltene, and so on. So in the recent years, we are highlighting the term for flow assurance, and also we are considering what about the balance between the maximum rate or the optimum production rate and the other one is the how is the continuity of this production rates. So it's considered in the area for flow assurance, and many books are considering the area for how is the production capacity enhancement. It's very, very critical because of what? Because we are highlighting what about the failure coming for any kind of well completion. It will not respect the area for flow assurance. It will not respect the area for tubing size sensitivity. It will not respect what about the perforation optimization and so on. So again, when we are considering the term for completion design parameters, we are highlighting the term for what about the wellbore configuration. So in wellbore configuration, we have two main ideas here. At first, what about the geometry? Geometry for what? Geometry for inclination, geometry for area of reservoir, a geometry of well trajectory, and so on. In the area for geometry, we have a specific area for vertical well. We have a specific area for horizontal well. Also, what about the casing size? Even if you are consider the completion of open hole, we are consider what about the open hole size, even the well trajectory, and also we are considering the term for perforation requirement and intervention requirement. So this is the first area of the wellbore configuration. The second area, we are considering the term for reservoir interface. What about reservoir interface? We are classify the well between producer and injector. And also we are define what about the open hole, what about the configuration for cased and perforated completion. And also we are considering what about the number of zones regarding the single zone and also multiple reservoirs or multiple zones. And also we are highlighting the term for sand production, as when we are considering any kind of well completion, when we are facing a problem with sand, we have two targets here. The first one, what about the temporary solution? And the second one as the permanent solution. and we are asking all people sharing with us, what about the permanent solution for sand production? Anyone can consider or can answer on this? When we are asking about the permanent solution for sand control or for sand production. Yes?
I think some permanent solutions for sand production are mentioned in this slide, such as gravel bag or flag bag, or slotted liners or slotted screens. Also, some companies, I think, they inject some kind of polymers or some kind of
reasons,
chemicals
yes.
in the reservoir in order to control the sand production rate from our
Yes.
reservoir.
Yes.
Also, some temporary solutions for
No,
this.
no, we are asking about the permanent solution. The
Okay.
temporary solution is to decrease the drawdown or to define the production rate and not reach to the critical rate for this well. So
Yes,
again,
sir.
we are considered the permanent solution. The permanent solution is to be considered in the area for sand control and well completion design regarding all you are mentioned screens, you are mentioned gravel bags, you are mentioned the pumping of reasons or any kind of treatment. All of this will be considered in the area for well completion as a permanent solution. Because of what? Because any temporary solution, it will delay the sand production, but after a certain time or after some of days or number of days, it will becoming the sand. So when we are considering the sand control, we are considering a lot of factors regarding the criteria for well completion, and also what about the best for fit for the installation. So when we are considering the area for how is the optimization coming, we are considering what about the reservoir challenges. Reservoir challenges, every problem, we are considered a problem as a challenge. And you are competing this challenge or you are facing this challenge to be success in the well completion process. When you are define what about the main reservoir challenges, at first, all oil and gas fields have a great problem for early water breakthrough. And in many cases, we are considering the early gas breakthrough, even if you have oil well with a gas interval or with a gas zone. And second one, we are considering the area for the high water production. It will be affected in the two area, the area for subsurface and the area for surface facilities. And the third reservoir challenges, we are considering the high gas production. We are also considering the solids and sand production. And also we are considering the unbalanced influx. So the reservoir challenges, it's the highlighted item or the highlighted topic in the well completion process. So when you are considering also what about the completion objective regarding what about the reservoir challenges, the completion objective, everyone, when we are defining what about the completion objective, at first you have to define what about the well target rate. The second one, you are defining what about the isolation interval inside the area for reservoir or bay zone. Also, we are consider what about the fracture control or any kind of isolation area. And the last one, you are think about how to overcome the above agreed reservoir challenges. So all of this, it will be an integrated process or integrated workflow to define a lot of problem or to define a lot of challenges inside the area for reservoir. So when we are considering all of this, we are considering the term for well data. Well data, it's a very, very critical term here to define all of the data coming from offset wells, coming from your completed wells, and so on. So again, when we are highlighting the term for the reservoir challenge, what about the idea coming for well completion in the area for water production? And how is the conventional completion will be failed in this area or will be not controlled in this area? And how is the smart will give you a great solution in this area? So again, when we are considering one of the main idea for how to maximize the profitability, the term for production optimization. So we have two ideas here. At first, the reservoir challenges. The second one as the completion objectives. And all of this will be considered in the area for how the integrated workflow and how the well data will be processed to get the production optimization. So one of the main idea also coming for the term for the formation damage or the formation skin. The formation skin or damage, it will add more delta B inside the area for inflow. So this area may be coming or in many cases coming from the completion design itself. In many cases, we have a lot of groups or we have a group of skin damage coming from the completion. The total skin coming from the completion or the completion design, maybe it will be a negative value or positive value. When we are considering the area for the total skin inside the area for completion, and we can define in many cases as the negative value for skin or positive value for skin. And the question now, how is this value will be negative or positive, will be indicated or will be affected by what? Anyone can describe this or answer this question? When we are considering the two value of skin as positive or negative, what about the impression or what about the effect of this? Yes. Yeah, yes, you can go, yeah. Yes, you can answer. Please answer, please.
Riyad Ali Shah, you can answer.
Yes.
You can unmute yourself.
Riyad Ali Shah, go ahead. Karar Saad, go ahead. Unmute yourself.
Okay, we have two value for the skin factor, positive value or zero or negative value. The positive yes. value meaning that the original permeability has been damaged by the different operation like by drilling fluid or completion or even perforations.
Yes.
Zero skin factor means that the original permeability is the same without any change during
yes,
the
but it, in many cases it's a theoretical value. No, zero, it's a theoretical value. So
yeah,
actually we have two values as positive and negative.
Negative.
You are highlighting the positive one. What about the negative one?
The negative one means that the permeability of the formation is enhanced and stimulated by two methods like fracturing or acidizing.
Yes.
In the general or in the end, we have good bare mobility for the fluid to flow from the formation to the wellbore.
Okay, that's right and correct answer. And the second question here, what about the well geometry regarding the vertical, regarding the deviated, and also regarding the horizontal well? When you are considering the term for productivity, or the term for enhancement. Can anyone describe what about the difference between the well geometry between vertical, deviated, and also the horizontal well in the term for well productivity? What about the main achievable target for the productivity coming from vertical well, deviated well, or horizontal well? So you can answer, please.
About the horizontal and the vertical, it depends on the properties do we have. I mean the reservoir properties. Like if we have low permeability, we can use horizontal. And if we have fracturing, we can use horizontal because the benefits of the horizontal is better to drill more vertical wells.
So again, when you are considering the term for productivity, you are highlighting the term for geometry for horizontal well regarding the area for the permeability ratio as KV per KH, as this is the permeability ratio between the vertical permeability and the horizontal permeability, as you mentioned. And this, in this case, if you are considering the term for the well geometry, it will give a high benefits for the horizontal well and also for the deviated well, and the less benefits or the lower benefits coming from vertical well. So again, it will be depends on the area for how is the completion design strategy, how is the target for how to maximize the profitability. You can drill one well and give a lot of targets and catch a lot of oil, a lot of gases, instead of drill more than four or five wells, but in same hole or same well, you are consider a lot of high term for how to maximize the profitability. It will be dependent on how the integrated workflow and how the well completion will give a benefits or will give a high objective in this case. So again, when we are considering the term for inflow performance relationship, we are considering two type of IBR. The first one as the bottom hole IBR coming from the reservoir pressure or external pressure. And the second one coming from how is the sand phase IBR or bottom hole flowing pressure. So in this case, we have a delta B here, or we have a difference in the pressure coming from how the fluid will be moved or will be transferred from the area of reservoir as a drainage area till we are reaching to the sand phase or the perforation, as is the first idea for IBR. The second idea here also coming from what about the tubing sensitivity coming. So the question now, when you are considering a lot of tubing size like tubing A, tubing B, tubing C, tubing D, tubing E, and the area for a tubing curve or the outflow performance curve. So in this case, when you are expecting, what about the larger tubing size and the smaller tubing size? Can anyone describe this, please? What about the larger size of tubing and the smaller size? Yes?
Okay, I will answer. My name is Karar.
Yes.
It's evidence from the figure tubing A is the smallest one because
tubing A is the
quantity
smallest
of the flow rate.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Because the flow rate is too low,
yes.
Very low. While in the tubing E is the largest one because it gives the higher production rate.
Okay. So the second question, and please answer on this. When you are selecting between the two tubing size, what about your selection? Selection will be tubing A or tubing E?
It's depend on sensitivity analysis or nodal analysis. It's not choice A or B. It's depend on the multi properties like bubble point pressure, like the
yes, correct, correct. So again, you are not consider the inflow model alone, or you are not consider the outflow model alone, but you are consider the integrated workflow coming from the production optimization or coming from the area for nodal analysis. It will be considered a lot of factors coming from the IBR or inflow, also coming from the area for outflow, and how is the integrated nodal analysis between the inflow and outflow, and also choke performance, surface facilities, separator performance, and so on. All of this will be considered in the area how is the tubing sensitivity will give you a high priority for what about the tubing size and how is this tubing size will be achieved or not. So again, when we are considering the term for the well completion, we are considering that well completion is the hardware of the outflow system and final stage of a drilled well. So the quality concept here for any kind of well completion is a quality well is a well which well contributes over its life cycle for reservoir for the well and give you a maximum monetary value without any kind of compromising of safety and environmental regulations or standard. So again, when we are considering the high quality process for the well completion, we are considering the term for how is the quality well is defined here. Is this well will be contribute more production or more sharing in the area for oil and gas or any kind of injection with extended life of reservoir. And also we are considering avoid any kind of operation will target or will be have a negative effect or negative impact on the area for environmental and safety regulations. So this is the idea coming from what? This is the idea coming from we are consider the well completion type, even it will be producer well, even maybe injector well, or maybe a kill well. So in this case, the well is either vertically and horizontal completed or deviated completed. So in this area, we have a lot of configurations regarding a lot of types of well completion, regarding open hole completion, regarding the uncemented liner completion, regarding the gravel bag or wrapped screen, wire wrapped screen, also regarding the tubingless completion, regarding the area for cemented and perforated completion. Also, we are considering the single string or multiple string completion. And by the end, we are consider the monobore completion. All of this will consider three main items here. Can anyone consider what about the three main item or three main elements when you are considering the different configuration of well completion? When you are considering the well completion configuration or well completion design type, what about the three main elements here inside the area for well completion design process? So at first, I'll highlight the area for inflow. It's the first one. The second one, it's the area for outflow model or outflow. And the third one, it's to consider what about the number of zones you are developed or you are produced from. So again, we are considering three main items here. At first, the inflow system. And the second one is the outflow system. And the third one is the number of zones. So when we are considering the area for well completion as a traditional or conventional completion, we have the area for conventional completion and the area for monobore completion. So it's the same idea here as the conventional completion will get a target for a single reservoir or multi-zones. And we are considering a lot of equipment or a lot of accessories here, as we mentioned after that. And inside the area for conventional, we have the same tubing size or same tubing ID, but we are not considering a lot of details or a lot of accessories, a lot of equipment, because we are considering or highlighting the term for well cost. So the question for all people sharing with us, what about the difference in cost between the conventional completion and well monobore completion? What about the high cost and low cost? Can anyone answer, please? Yes. Yes, you can answer. Yeah.
I think the conventional completion, which has a lot of accessories, will cost a lot compared to the monobore completion. But
so the high cost will be, or the high expensive will be conventional, and the low cost will be monobore. So yes. Okay, now we are targeting what about the different configuration or different design considerations. We have three design considerations here, starting from the inflow, the second one is the outflow, and the third one, the number of producing zones. So in the area for inflow, we have to target what about the reservoir geometry regarding vertical well and the horizontal well. Inside the area for vertical well, we have a lot of configurations of the design considerations regarding open hole, regarding the area for uncemented liner, regarding the area for pre-perforated liner, and also regarding the area for perforated casing. In the area for the second item or second element here as the outflow, we have two main classes here or categories here, starting from the primary recovery. It's considered as the natural flow or the high pressure or high energy for drive any kind of fluid coming from the formation fluid or pumped inside the area for formation fluid. And the secondary recovery, as we are targeting the term for the artificial lift. Outflow here, it's considered the production strategy or the production philosophy. The third one, or the third element here, we are highlighting the term for what about the number of reproducing zones. At first, we have a single zone, and the second one, we have a multiple zone. So in many cases, you are not consider one of the configuration here, but we are considering a lot of configurations regarding at first, what about the design consideration, regarding what about the element of inflow system, outflow system, and number of zones. And after that, you will select what about the proper design configuration or what about the proper type of completion design. At first, we are highlighting the term for inflow. So the inflow coming from the reservoir boundary till we are reaching to the sand face or the perforation area. The second element, we are considering the outflow. It will be considered the interface between the wellbore here till we are reaching to the surface facilities. And the third element, we are targeting what about the number of zones, even maybe have a single zone or maybe have a multi-zones, maybe two, three, four, and so on. All of this will be considered in the area for design consideration or the completion type. So when we are starting with the area for inflow, we are highlighting what about the vertical well or what about the horizontal well. And in many cases, we are highlighting what about the benefits or what about the targets of the vertical and horizontal well. As we mentioned, in the inflow system, we have a lot of configuration regarding vertical well, starting from open hole like this. It will be a formation here. It will be open hole. The second one, it will be a slotted liner. The third one, it will be mesh wrapped screens or wrapped screens, wire wrapped screens or screens or gravel back. It will be considered the area for sand control. And the last one will be gravel back only. So the inflow system have a lot of configurations or have a lot of consideration here or a lot of fluid well completion configuration. The second one, when we are highlighting the other type of inflow system inside the area for vertical, we are considering the standard configuration regarding the cemented and cased hole area. And also regarding the interval gravel back, it will be focused in same area or same formation with will be gravel back by a system of gravel back to consider and control the sand. The second item or the second class here, when we are consider the inflow system inside the area for horizontal well, so we have a lot of configurations here regarding open hole. When we are penetrating the horizontal section with the open hole, and we are considered the second type as a slotted liner, pre-bagged screens, gravel back, cement, and perforated liner. And also, in the second element or the second design consideration, we are considering the term for outflow. At first, we are considering the term for primary recovery. Primary recovery, so the well will be able by the life of pressure, the area for how is the facilities to consider the primary recovery. So in primary recovery, at first we have a consideration for the primary recovery for design consideration or the design configuration of tubingless. This well is completed without any kind of tubing. And the second one as the high pressure will be cemented, perforated and completed with a production tubing and all completion accessories like this. And the third one as the monobore completion, it will be with a high rate liner and also it will be a cost-effective design configuration. the second class or the second category for the outflow, it will be considered the secondary recovery. Secondary recovery here is respecting what about the artificial lift will be applied in the term for how the means of production. So we have a lot of configuration here regarding what about the saccharide pumping, how is the hydraulic pumping or jet pump, and also regarding what about the gas lift, even it will be intermittent gas lift or continuous gas lift, and also regarding what about the ESB, and also what about the BCB, and so on. All of this, it considered what about the means of reduction regarding the artificial lift methodology or the artificial lift technique when you are using. So when you are considering the area for secondary recovery, we are highlighting two main ideas here. At first, we are targeting how to lighten the hydrostatic fluid of oil column or hydrocarbon column. It will be considered the gas lift. And the second one, it will be considered how to lift or how to increase the force or energy for fluid lifting force. It will be considered any kind of artificial lift pump regarding ESB, saccharide pump, and so on. And again, we are considering the area for how is the selection criteria for artificial lift regarding a lot of parameters, regarding a lot of details to define how, what about the service fit for your system. The third item or the third element in the area for design consideration is to consider what about the producing zones. Even at first category, we have a single zone. For single zone, we have a lot of configurations regarding single completion, single selective interval, single selective or single commingle. Also, we are considering the second category for what about the multiple zones. In multiple zones, as a traditional or conventional completion, we are highlighting what about the multiple completion as a dual completion or in many cases, triple completion. And also we are considering what about the a lot of workers, we are using a lot of SSDs, a lot of completion equipment. All of this, we are considering or we are thinking about the traditional or conventional completion. But when we are transfer for the technology of a smart, we are considering the term for how is the monitoring, how is the control, and how is the production optimization inside the area for downhole to touch your reservoir and to approach what about the maximize reservoir connectivity and how to maximize the profitability inside the area for oil completion design. So in this area, we are considering at first, what about the vertical wellbore profile? In vertical wellbore profile, actually no great productivity coming or no great productivity benefit coming. Also may catch unwanted water or gas without any kind of control. And also it will be preferred for fracturing. Inside the area for fracturing, the vertical well, it will be the best model or the proper model for fracturing. The second configuration as a deviated wellbore profile, in this case, we are actually increase the term for productivity, especially in thin reservoir or tight reservoirs. And also we are extend the reservoir lifetime or reservoir reach inside the area for the deviated well. The last one as the horizontal wellbore profile, it will be considered that we have a significant increase in productivity. We have to reduce the influence of skin or the effect of skin. And also we are reducing the effect of cooling or any kind of gas breakthrough. So in this case, when we are considering or highlighting the area for open hole through reservoir, it will not be effective nowadays because of what? Because actually you have a maximum area to flow, but the hole stability, it's a great factor here. Also, you have to control what about the heterogeneity inside the area of a reservoir and so on. But actually, we are also considered in the open hole completion, the area for unconsolidated formation. So the question now for all people, what about the unconsolidated formation? You are preferred to complete the well with the open hole or cased and perforated or cased and cemented hole? What about the preferable well completion configuration. So you can, yeah, you can go, yeah. Yes.
I think for unconsolidated formations, the best completion type is to be cased and perforated, and if the unconsolidation is severe, we may use gravel bag.
Yes, yes, this is the idea. The idea coming from the configuration, it will be governed, it will be controlled regarding the type of your formation. Also regarding what about the unconsolidated sand or what about the unconsolidated formation. So as you mentioned, we are highlighting that the open hole completion, it's not preferred in the area for the unconsolidated reservoirs or the unconsolidated formation. So in many cases, we are considering also the area for how is the reservoir section inside the area for cased, cemented, and perforated completion. It will be better control of reservoir. Also, the multiple zones through a single well, it will be preferred here, and better isolation options. And also, the unconsolidated sand, it will be governed by a gravel bag or any kind of rack bag or any kind of screens, any kind of sand control mechanism. Also, one of the main idea when we are considering the multi-zone completion configuration. Here is the four zones we are considering. This is the first one, the second one, and third one, and fourth one. So in conventional and traditional completion, inside the area for multiple zones, it will be have a headache, or it will be have a great challenges here, and we will be have a suffer from a lot of failures or a lot of problems. So the question now, can anyone consider that? What about the severity, or what about the criticality for the multiple zones or multiple completion inside the area for conventional or traditional completion? What about the challenges, or what about the criticality here? Yes.
Abdullah Zanti, go ahead. Unmute
yes.
yourself. Abdullah, can you hear me?
It may cause a back pressure if a zone has a higher pressure than the other.
Yes, because maybe a high pressure zone and low pressure zone. So the back pressure, it will be found, yes. What about the other effect? Like water or gas production, more oil, more water, more gas production coming from zones, it will be unwanted or undesired inside the area for production. Also, what about the cross flow? Also, what about the controlling element? Because of what? Because a lot of engineers may be interested in the area. What about the allocation, or what about the production sharing coming from the reservoirs? So it's very, very critical to know what about the criticality here. So Abdullah, again, you can share what about the criticality here, or the challenges here. So again, we have a lot of challenges here regarding what about the production contribution from each zone, what about the back pressure, or what about the unwanted fluid regarding excess of water, excess of gas coming from each zone. Even the permeability contrast between each zone, between high permeable layer and low permeable layer, and so on. Even a lot of factors here. What about the well intervention coming? What about the workover operation, and so on? So again, when we are considering the well completion, we are highlighting in the area for design considerations as the well type between producer well, injector well, and kill well. And also we are considering the area for consideration of the design regarding inflow system, outflow system, and the number of zones. And in these cases, we are highlighting what about the well completion process. The well completion, it's a very, very critical process. It will be handled a lot of factors, a lot of input data. So the process of design of well completion is very critical and very, very challenging to be identified here. So in traditional completion, we are considering a lot of factors here. the first factor as the what about the well completion equipment or well completion tools or well completion accessories inside the area for the traditional or conventional completion. So in this case, in conventional completion, we have five groups. The first group as the anchoring device. What about the anchoring device? We are using the anchoring device as a landing nibbles to receive any kind of flow control device, any kind of lugs, any kind of memory gauges, any kind of tool, and so on. And the second group, we are highlighting what about the circulation device. Circulation device, we are considering any kind of mean or any kind of accessory we are using to give a communication between tubing and annulus, or give you the benefit or the profit or the ability for a circulation between tubing and annulus regarding the two types of circulation device in traditional or conventional completion. At first as SSD, as a sliding side door, and the second one as the side bucket mandrel, like this. So the third group, it's considered what about the isolation device. The isolation device is considered the function of how to isolate between the tubing area and the casing area to control the fluid coming from the reservoir to go through directly to the tubing till reaching the surface without any deviation regarding the area of casing or the annulus side. So in this area, we have two main kind of isolation device. At first, the backer, and the second one as the tubing seal assembly, or BBR as polished bore receptacle. And the fourth group, we are considering the term for anti-erosion device. Anti-erosion device, because when we are flowing any kind of well, we have a lot of criteria for erosion. Erosion coming from what? Coming from the high velocity of fluid and also the high delta B inside the area for obstruction or inside the area of tubing. So in this area, we have two types of anti-erosion device. Because of what? Because the erosion coming from external, like we are reducing this zone inside of tubing or opposite of tubing. So we are using the term for blast joint here. It will be a heavy thickness or heavy thick tubing joint. And when you are consider the internal erosion, like when are considering any kind of delta B, more delta B, or the critical velocity inside the restriction inside the area for tubing, we are considering the area for downhill safety valve. So in this case, we are defining the flow coupling benefit. And the fifth group or the last group, we are considering the other accessory regarding wireline entry guide. It will guide the wireline to be pulled out again from the hole. Also the perforated bob joint, the control line to control the pressure coming for any kind of downhole safety valve, and also the tubing hanger to hang and suspend the area of tubing inside the wellhead. So in this case, again, we have five groups of well completion accessories in the area for traditional completion, starting from at first the anchoring device, the second one as the circulation device, the third group as the isolation device, the fourth one as the anti-erosion device, and the others group regarding wireline entry guide, control line, perforated bob joint, and also the tubing hanger. So in this case, we are define or give an overview about the well completion accessory and the area for conventional or traditional completion. At first group, we are highlighting what about the anchoring device. The anchoring device will be considered a short tubular joint or a short tubular bob joint with three main features. The first one, as we have a shoulder, and the second one, as we have a seal bore area, and the third one, we have a profile. So in this case, we have a lot of types of nibble regarding the use of this nibble. At first one, as this is the ported nibble or safety valve nibble, here is the safety valve nibble, as the first one from the left side. And the second one here as the ported nipple, and the two last one from the right side, it will be the top and bottom no-go nipple. So in this case, we are considering in the area for nipple, the two main element. The nipple profile have the area for key profile here, and have the area for a seal bore area. So in this case, we have to utilize that any kind of plug or any kind of flow control device will be controlled or will be hanged by the lock mandrel inside the area for profile, and also will be controlled by many cases. We are using the term for top no-go nipple. If you have a no-go in the top area like this one, this one is have a tubing area for or the area for top no go, and the above one or the upper one we are the area for a bottom no go. So in this case we are considering the function of nipple. What about the main function of landing nipple inside the area for well completion design? Anyone can describe the main function for the landing nipple? Yes, you can go, yeah.
You have already mentioned you have already mentioned those as main functions of landing nipples. It is an anchoring points. We can use it to set plugs, test the tubing,
yes.
Or we can use it to install
any kind of memory gauge, yes.
Memory gauges, or some kind of downhole chokes or regulators in
yes.
case of high pressure wells, gas wells, and so on. We also may use it to correlate depths using slick line or
yes, but the correlation for depths, it's not the main objective. It will be a secondary target for, or the secondary
yes.
objective for the landing nipple. So correct.
Yes.
At first, we are highlighting the term for landing nipples. It will be an anchoring device to receive any kind of for flow control device regarding the plugs, regarding gauges, regarding check valves, and so on, or any kind of testing plug. And this is the main idea here for, or the main objective for the landing nipples. The second objective, it will be maybe it will be for depth correlation. Maybe it considered as the area for restriction or the area for restriction inside the tubing to avoid any kind of drop of equipment inside the rat hole. It will be considered as the secondary target for the landing nipples. So when we are considering the area for downhole safety valve, it will be considered as a safety critical element. The term for safety critical element, any kind of installation, any kind of device, when we are using in the area for emergency or a contingency case, it will be considered as a safety critical element. So the downhole safety valve, actually we have two class or two groups for downhole safety valve. The first one as the passive, as it will be have a passive controlled or downhole safety valve controlled. And the second one, it will be the surface control subsurface safety valve. The first one, it's an obsolete technology and expired technology. And the last one, or the second one, it will be utilized today as a surface control subsurface safety valve. And we have two types of this. At first one, we are considering the wireline retrievable safety valve. And the second one, we are considering the tubing retrievable safety valve. And we have a benefits coming from the wireline retrievable, and also we have a limitation here, and also we have a benefits, and also we have a limitation for tubing retrievable safety valve. And the question now, what about the benefit coming from the wireline retrievable safety valve? Yes. Yes, you can answer, please. What is the benefits coming from the wireline retrievable safety valve? And also the limitation, the benefits, or the main benefits coming from the wireline retrievable safety valve, as this valve, it will be retrieved and redressed again more time. But the limitation, the main limitation here, it will be considered the more restriction inside the flow area or equivalent flow area of the tubing, and also more delta B, more friction losses inside the area for downhole safety valve. But the second one, as a tubing retrievable, it gave a full bore area, or the full area for flow. And also it will be considered as an integral part of tubing, as a permanent part of tubing. But the main limitation is how to solve the problem if we are have a problem like failure inside the area for system of flubber or ball valve, and also for system of control line. In this case, you have to give another solution to put an inserted valve inside this area after you are black this or shut off this area or isolate this area. So again, in this case, we have a different configuration for downhole safety valve as safety critical element. Considering what about the type of mean for surface control, subsurface safety valve of control, it gave a value for control line. It will be coming from the surface till we are reaching to the downhole safety valve depths. With a pressure, this pressure will be activate the mechanism for open and close for flubber or ball system. This is the flubber tubing retrievable safety valve. And the other one, it will be considered the wireline inserted valve or wireline retrievable safety valve. So again, when we are considering the term for the isolation device, we are considering the term for a safety critical element as the downhole safety valve. And the question now for all participants, when you are highlighting the term for a safety critical element as a downhole safety valve or triple SV, you are consider that the triple SV, it's a very, very great equipment here. And we have to define what about the integrity program or the integrity testing for this valve. Can anyone consider or describe what about the integrity testing for the downhole safety valve? Yes. Yes, you can answer, yeah. Yes, please answer, yeah.
M.M, go ahead.
I think at the field they close the triple S and inflow the triple S. They close the subsurface safety valve, bleed
yes.
pressure above it, and monitor the
monitor
pressure.
The pressure buildup. Yes, you are mentioned one of the tests as the inflow test.
So, and I think test. There is another test which is called the function test, which
yes.
Usually
open and close.
Opening and the closing and the monitoring is a pressure at which the flubber fully opens and
yes.
the number of strokes. This will show if the flubber is opening or closing, and the pressure test will determine if the subsurface safety valve holds the pressure or not.
Yes, yes. Again, you are considered two type of test in the integrity testing for downhill safety valve. At the first one as the integrity test as a function test, and the second one as the operational test or inflow test. The function test is to open and close the flubber valve or the ball valve many times to consider the function of this valve to open and close. And the second one as the inflow test is to pressure test this valve inside the area or into the area for a flow direction flow. So in this case, you are closing this valve and the bleed of the pressure above this valve. You are monitoring what about the pressure buildup coming. And in this case, you have two criteria for what about the testing results. At first, maybe hold for pressure. And the second one may be leak. And the third one, it will be passing for a minor leak or acceptable leak regarding the recommended practice coming from EBI, coming from ISO standard, or coming from NORSUK standard. In this case, the second group in the area for traditional or conventional completion, we have the circulation device. So, in the area for conventional or traditional completion, we have two types of circulation device. At first, the sliding side door, and the second one as the side bucket mandrel. As you see here in the right side is the sliding side door. Sliding side door here have inner sleeve. This inner sleeve will be moved up or down to define what about the opening and closing this the area for SSD. So we are opening this area, we are allow for circulation and communication between tubing and casing. And the second one, as the second side bucket mandrel, it will be considered a means of communication or circulation regarding this area as a receptacle area for any kind of valve regarding gas lift valve, regarding a circulation valve, chemical injection valve, also as the equalizing valve. And in many cases, we are considering this area to be blocked or to be dumped as we are using the dummy valve. It will be blocked this area. All of this will be considered as we have two main idea for circulation devices. First one as the side bucket mandrel and the second one as the sliding side door or SSD. Here is the area for or the photo for the SSD here and the second one as the side bucket mandrel and the third one here as the gas lift valves we are using inside this area for side bucket mandrel. So we are consider that we are asking all people here, what about the maximum or the bigger ID for completion accessory? What is the item for bigger ID or larger ID inside the area for a wheel completion? Yes. Yes, you can answer, please.
M.M, go ahead.
Yes.
M.M, can you hear me?
Yes.
I think the larger area is for the side bucket mandrel.
Yes, yes, the larger area for the well completion accessory, it will be for side bucket mandrel, and it will be considered as the area for receiving and applying the area for any kind of gas lift valve, any kind of orifice, any kind of dummy valve, and so on. So the third group will be considered as the isolation device. In the term for isolation device, we are using the term for production buffer. So in this case, we have three types of production buffer. At first one as a permanent buffer, the second one as a retrievable buffer, and the third one as inflatable straddle buffer. The first one as a permanent buffer, it's considered for high pressure well, considered for the extended life time of the well, or the lifetime will be longer than the other types. And also it will be considered, what about the means of setting, means of retrieving, even in the permanent buffer, it will be considered as a millable buffer. And when you are talking about the second type as a retrievable buffer, retrievable buffer considered for the integral part of tubing, and it will be run on the production tubing. And also it will be considered the main mechanism for setting is the hydraulic mechanism. And the other type or the last type of buffer as the inflatable or straddle buffer, mainly it will be used in the area for wear intervention or testing, like any kind of RTTS buffer. RTTS is considered as a retrievable testing and the treatment straddle system buffer, many types of chin buffer, and so on. All of this is considered as the straddle buffer or the inflatable buffer system. So in this case, when we are considering the term for the buffer, we are considering three main properties you are highlighting when you are purchasing or when you are ordering any kind of buffer. The first one, the size of buffer with the range of casing weight. This is the first one. The second property you are highlighting, what about the differential pressure of buffer? Many people asking for working pressure, but inside the area of buffer or inside the area for plugs, we are highlighting the term for differential pressure, not working pressure. The third one is we are considering that the type or the means of retrieving this type of buffer. Many kind of buffer is drillable, like bridge plug or like isolation buffer. Also, many type of buffer, some types of buffer is considered as millable regarding permanent type. And also many type of buffer is considered as the retrievable. And so on. All of this will be considered the means of retrieving or the means of recovery. So the question now, What about the priority or the risk of risk factor inside the area for retrieving or recovery of this packer? Because of what? Because the worst case, you are considered this packer will be recovered inside the area for workover and recompletion operation. So the main item inside the area for property or specification is the how to retrieve or the retrieving mechanism for this packer. So the basic packer configuration, it will be isolate any kind of casing string from any kind of fluid. Also, it will be define how is the capability for isolation, how is the capability for setting mechanism. And in this case, you have to know that we have two different mechanisms for packer. The first one as the hanging mechanism, the packer, it will be used high slips to define the area for hanging. And by second, we are using the term for how is the sealing mechanism. And this two mechanism is different in operation, different in the philosophy of Barker, and also different in mechanism. The first one as the hanging mechanism, and the second one as the setting mechanism. And the question now, the idea for a Barker running, the idea for Barker running, when you are running a kind of Barker, even it will be essential to hanging the Barker at first, and the second one make a seal or to prepare a seal inside the area for Barker depths or Barker location. This is the idea here. The fourth group of well completion is the anti-erosion device. We are considering at first one as the plus joint, and the second one as the flow coupling. The plus joint is a heavy walled thickness tubing, and also it's considered as one of the main anti-erosion device defined for external or prevent the external erosion. In this case, when you are produce any kind of interval or any kind of perforation opposite the tubing profile, it will be considered and highlighted the benefit of coming from the plus joint. The second type of anti-erosion device, it's the flow coupling. Flow coupling, it's considered as a heavy walled tubular, but it's installed the system for telescopic system here like this to define the, to identify what about the turbulence flow, how the delta B will be equalized and will be defined. And the question now for all people sharing with us, when you are considering one flow coupling inside the area for well completion, and you have a downhole safety valve, what is the correct area or the correct place you will put the flow coupling? Will be above or will be below the downhole safety valve? Yes, M.ME, you can answer. Yeah. Yes.
I think it will be above it because our downstream of the valve, because
yes, because of what?
There will be a lot of turbulence.
Yes.
So this region will be subjected to high erosional velocity, which may cause erosion of regular tubulars. So we need a heavy walled tubular like flow coupling to decrease or to withstand
to prevent the internal erosion coming from the high delta B, the high velocity, and also the area for friction, more friction losses or more restriction inside the area for downstream of element regarding downhole safety valve. Like this configuration, we are highlighting in this wheelbar sketch here. We are highlighting one flow coupling. We are consider that the flow coupling position will be above the area for downhole here. It will be inside the area for downstream. This is the area for upstream, and the upper one, it's will be the area for the downstream. So again, it will be considered in the area for the anti-erosion device. We are considering two devices, the first one as the plus joint and the second one as the flow coupling. The first one, we are highlighting the term for external erosion as a blast joint. To prevent the external erosion, we are using the blast joint. And to prevent the area for internal erosion, we are considering the flow coupling. The last group are considered the others group like wireline entry guide. Wireline entry guide like the bell type here or the half mole show here. It will consider as it will guide any kind of wireline tool coming again inside the area for tubing. And also the perforated bob joint, it will eliminate the flow controlled even inside the area for pressure gauges, because pressure gauges will be define a more restriction or a minor flow area. And the perforated joint will give a high a maximum equivalent flow area in this case. And the third one as the control line, it will transport or transfer the area for hydraulic flow to the triple SV. And also it will be continuous length and it will have a clamped and also straps inside the area for tubing. Also the last one is the tubing hanger. It will be set inside the area for tubing head spool to suspend and hang the tubing and will be give high priority for this. So this is the function of perforated bob joint. When you are using a pressure gauge here inside the area for bottom hole, for bottom nipple here, and you have a gauge here, this gauge will give a restriction in this area. So the perforated bob joint will give a high priority here to increase the equivalent flow area and to identify here what about the function of perforated bob joint. The second criteria here is how is the integration coming from a lot of completion accessories inside the area for traditional and conventional completion regarding downhole safety valve, regarding landing nipples, regarding side bucket mandrel, regarding SSD, regarding backer, regarding anti-erosion device, and so on. All of these completion accessories inside the area of the traditional or conventional completion will be integrated with the term for tubing. So the tubing joint or any kind of bob joint, it will be defined at first by the tubing diameter, the tubing connection type, and also the tubing metallurgy regarding what about the carbon steel tubing or any kind of corrosion resistance alloy like 13 chrome, 18% chrome, or 22 or stainless steel chrome. So in this case, we are considering what about the female and male or bin and box. Also, we are considering what about the thread type or connection type regarding EBI connection or premium connection for metal to metal seal, more gas seal thread like VAM top or VAM family. And also, we are considering, we are both a criteria for selection any kind of tubing. You have to define the term for forces and stresses. So the forces and stresses, it's defined at first by what about the tension or loads, the second one as the compression, and the third one as the term for collapse, and the last one, the term for burst. And the question now for all people, what about the difference or what about the comparison between collapse and burst? Anyone can describe this, please? What is the difference between two property of burst and collapse?
I think collapse is a failure of the tubing due to the pressure from inside, so or from outside. The pressure from outside will collapse the pipe. This and the other failure method, which is burst. This is a failure of the tubing under high pressure from inside.
Yes, yes, you are correct in your answer. The burst will be give high priority for internal pressure. And the collapse gave a high priority for external pressure. And in this case, you have to define what about the worst case. Worst case is burst or worst case is collapse. When you are designed for any kind of tubing, any kind of tubular, what about the worst case? Worst case is burst or collapse? Yes, the question. Yes. Yes. Omar, you can answer.
Well, I think burst.
Yes.
Because
yes.
The main risk is the pressure from inside the tubing.
Yes, you are correct. The burst is the worst case because the high severity or the high risk coming from the internal pressure. So the burst is the worst condition. So again, when you are considering the other detailed specification for any kind of tubing, we are consider what about the size and dimension regarding what about the ID, OD, and weight inbound per feet, how is the material grade, the standard define two item here. At first, we are define a letter. This letter is considered what about the letter or naming of this material regarding the kind of collapse, the kind of material or manufacturing. And the other one is the number. This number is considered as the minimum yield strength. So when we are considering as example here, J55, it's considered the material grade is J, and 55 is the 55,000 PSI as the minimum yield strength. Minimum yield strength. So the other area we are considering the tubing connection. Also, we have a lot of criteria for the EBI connection or premium joint. And also we are considering the how is the construction regarding seamless pipe, and also regarding what about the standard here. So in this case, we are highlighting here is the table to show or to represent the area for tubing performance properties. Here is the maximum diameter or OD, and also here is the inside diameter, here is the drift data, here is the other data regarding the thread and coupling, regarding the length, also regarding collapse, regarding the internal yield or internal burst pressure, and so on. All of this is considered as what about the tubing data performance regarding the material grade, regarding the collapse, regarding the yield strength, and so on. All of this will be considered here as how is the selection criteria for any kind of well completion tubing. So in this case, we are considering the term for material selection. This is the a very, very simple guideline for select the well completion material. Regarding the area for material grade, and also regarding the area for how is the carbon steel and how is the corrosion resistance alloy. In this case, you have to input the data for what about the CO2 or carbon dioxide content inside the formation fluid or your stream. You are considered the hydrogen sulfate content. Also, you are considered what about the bottom hole pressure and bottom hole temperature. And after that, you are considered what about the power of hydrogen or pH value of your produced fluid. So at first case or first step, you have to calculate two items here. The first one as the partial pressure of H2S and also the partial pressure of CO2 as carbon dioxide and hydrogen sulfide. The partial pressure of H2S, as this is the equation coming from bottom hole pressure multiplied by the CO2 in mole percent over 100, it will give a partial pressure of CO2 as a carbon dioxide. At same case, but here is the equation, we'll consider the H2S content in part per million, per 1 million, multiplied by the area for the value for bottom hole pressure. So in this case, you have to define what about the decision coming, for, if you have a partial pressure for CO2 more than 10 PSI, it will be considered the area for the higher corrosion resistance alloy regarding what about the NIST standard and also regarding this chart coming from the different types of corrosion resistance alloy coming from 13 chrome, 18% chrome till we are reaching to 22 or the duplex stainless steel. The other factors or the other parameters will be considered what about the value for pressure, for partial pressure for H2S, and will guide you what about the recommended grades we are using. Here is the N80 or B110, K55, and so on. All of this will consider the area for material selection as it's defined as a very, very simple guideline for material selection. And also here is define what about the range between the carbon steel and the other factor for corrosion resistance alloy, regarding the term for partial pressure for H2S and CO2, and also regarding the term for temperature. All of this will be considered in the area for material selection. So material selection is very, very critical inside the area for completion design. And also it's very, very critical for the idea for how to maximize the profitability coming from your well. And also are highlighting what about the tubing sensitivity here. Tubing sensitivity here, as we mentioned, that the tubing size is very critical for the area for well completion design and or the area for productivity inside the area for well completion process. And in this case, we are highlighting the last item today as the wellhead and Christmas tree. So in the industry, we have two terms. It's a different term. As the first one, as the wellhead, as the bottom part, till we are reaching to the tubing head spool, we are reaching for a wellhead section. And the other part regarding all valves to operate the well, it will be considered as a Christmas tree. So when we are starting the area for wellhead, the wellhead have a function to anchor and suspend the any kind of casing or any kind of string inside it, and also give a pressure isolation and the integrity for any kind of concentric tubing inside the area for casing. And also it will give the area for how to suspend and hang any kind of casing inside the area for a spool. So in this case, we have a lot of criteria for wellhead. The first one, as we are highlighting the term for the two main types on the wellhead, as the first one as a spool type, and the second one as a compact type. Even a lot of criteria here regarding what about the criteria for each casing have a certain specification for casing spool or casing head. This casing head have a certain area for casing hanger, have a certain area for valve as outlet valve here, coming from one side or two sides. And also we are considering how is the testing or how is the area for the bore area for testing any kind of hanger, any kind of profile area. And the other case, we are using the term for Christmas tree. In this area, we have a lot of types of valve regarding the upper master valve here as the last one here. The lower master valve here is the last one. The upper one is the upper master valve. It will be normally, it will be actuator regarding pneumatic or hydraulic control. And also we have highlight the swap valve. Swap valve, it's considered as the gate or the door for your well to have a permission for any kind of well intervention. The other types of valves as a wing valve here, as a choke, even it will be fixed or adjustable. And also the other type of valve, not on all well regarding the kill wing valve. So the question now, when you are considering any kind of well intervention and you have to close one of these valves to pressure test the rig up for you and the well intervention regarding wireline coil tubing, what is the type of valve you are selecting here? Yes. M.M can answer, yeah? For well intervention, yeah. Yes?
For well intervention operation, I think they close the upper master valve, so they can pressure test all the BCE, also with the surface lines, and
yes, you are mentioned upper master valve. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Anyone can answer? Can answer another answer? Yes. Okay.
Also, we might close the swap valve, and if we have a bump in sub from...
No, you are selecting two options, but we have a correct answer. It's
just the swap valve. Just
the swap valve. Yes. The swap valve, it's the high priority for any kind of well intervention, any kind of permission to access inside the well to test any kind of rig above the well. It will be the first priority for the swap valve. So in your case, when you are considered, what about the safety critical element inside the area for Christmas tree? What about the safety critical element valve here? Anyone can describe?
The safety critical element is the lower master valve.
Again, safety critical element, it will be considered any kind of element or any kind of device you are using inside the area or in case of emergency or contingency. So in case of emergency or contingency, you have to define any kind of remote controlled area or any kind of remote controlled device, like downhole safety valve. What about the safety critical element valve here? Not the lower master valve. Yes?
It
will be the upper
it's
master
the upper master.
It is hydraulic actuated.
Yes. Any kind of upper master valve or any kind of actuator valve, it will be considered, or actuator, it will be considered as a safety critical element. So as the lower master valve is a manual valve, so it will be not respected inside the area for safety critical element. Even the lower master valve, it's not working valve in optimum condition. So it will be the last defense line. So we have to respect the area for integrity test as a function, and also inflow test for this Christmas tree valves. And also we have to respect that we have a lot of types of Christmas tree regarding the area for solid block, and the left side here. This is the solid block. It will be considered for the high pressure well, and it's considered as one of the integral part of the Christmas tree. And also the second type as the composite or loose valve, it will be considered as a valves are located on a separate block and joined by the kind of rule of ABI flange regarding the ID and also the working pressure. And also it will be considered the area for ring gaskets. The last one is the horizontal Christmas tree like this. It will be considered for any kind of subsea well or deep water well. Inside the area for marine or offshore deep water area. And also we are highlighting that any kind of wellhead connection, it will be follow a rule of EBI flange. It will be considered two term of EBI flange rule. At first is the ID, here is the ID, and here is the working pressure. Even if you are consider here the flange as per ABI specification, it's considered ID as inside diameter and also consider the working pressure. So also consider what about the ring gaskets regarding the RX type, regarding B and BX type. All of this will be considered in the area for wellhead and Christmas tree. Even it will be subject to apply the EBI standard as EBI 6A standard or the alternative ISO. Also, it will be considered what about the flange rule side and so on. All of this will be considered as even here is the single well or single Christmas tree. And in many cases, we have the criteria for dual completion. And if this dual completion will be operated by a dual Christmas tree, in this dual Christmas tree, you have two area. The first one is a long side area here in the right side. And the left side, we are defined the short string area. And all of this passes, it will be separated. And also in the area for tubing hanger separate, long string will be separate of the stream of the short string to avoid any kind of cross flow or any kind of communication and so on. All of this will be considered as the last of day one, as we are highlighting all of items or all of accessories inside the area for conventional or traditional completion. And tomorrow we are go through the other part or the other technology as the smart completion technology. By the end of day one, thank you for your kind attention. And anyone have any question, I can go, yeah.
Engineer Mahmoud, you have mentioned that there are three types of wells, production, injection, and kill wells.
Yes.
What is the definition of a kill well? I didn't get it.
Yes, kill well, it's utilized. What about the option or what about the operation coming? Kill well, it's considered as any kind of suspended well or any kind of well you are need to be secured or to be killed inside the operation. It will be considered as a kill well, even if you have the area for a blue out coming from some well, you are consider the offset well as a kill well. Offset well to kill the area for reservoir, it's considered as also a kill well. Any kind of securing well, it will be fixed or it will be a permanent solution as to be kill well. This is the area for kill well. And also nowadays we are considered the area for disposal well. It will be considered also for the environmental regulation to dispose any kind of water, any kind of unwanted fluid inside this well.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes, can anyone have any question, please?
Does anyone have any other question? Please raise your hand and unmute yourself and ask. Okay, Muhammad, you can go ahead. Muhammad Ali.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Mahmoud Faraj Radwan, for this valuable information about evaluation of full completion. We look forward to seeing you all tomorrow for the second part of the lecture.
Yes.
Everyone, okay. Thank you, Mr. Mahmoud.
Thank you, Mr. Muhammad, for everything. And thank you for the attending and accepting the invitation.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, everyone, please fill out the attendance form via the link sent in the chat, and you can lift. Thank you, Mr. Mahmoud. We look forward tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. See you tomorrow, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Thank you.